Today's halacha, continuing with the halachot of Birkat HaMazon. We again learned that Birkat HaMazon, according to the Rambam and the Sfaradim, is the only Torah obligation blessing that we make in a day. Now it's very interesting, you can make it a couple times a day. Every time you eat a meal, a bread meal, you can do Birkat HaMazon. Now on what substance do we make Birkat HaMazon? We're going to deal with that. The first thing he deals with this morning is the Rambam. What if a person forgot to do Birkat HaMazon? Or what if a person's in doubt if they did Birkat HaMazon or not? Do they do it? How long do they have to do it? Someone ate at 9 a.m. 3, 4 o'clock. Oh, I forgot to do Birkat HaMazon. Do you do Birkat HaMazon or not? Let's see. A person ate a bread meal, he forgot and he did not do the Birkat HaMazon. He fulfilled the saying, Achalta, Savata, Ubarachta. He ate, he was satiated, and he ran away. He did not berach. Chazak. Im nizkar kodem shitakel ha'achal b'me'av, hozer umvarech. If it's within the time that the food is still in the midst of digesting in his stomach, then he will still go back and make the Birkat HaMazon, which, halachically speaking, the Chachamim nowadays have told us that that is around 72 minutes. If you're within 72...
But he has to come back to the place
where he came. So we'll speak about that. The Rambam doesn't speak about that, we'll speak about that. So let's do one thing at a time. So if it's within the time that it's still digesting, now yes, we know 6 hours meat and it's that, but what it means by nitakel bime'av, meaning, do you still feel satiated from that meal? You know, if you eat a sandwich, 72 minutes later, you could eat something else. You might not be starving, but right after you eat a big meal, you know, sometimes you gotta... you know, find room for dessert. It's so appetizing, it's so tasty. But in 72 minutes, you won't need to find room for dessert. It will find its own place. That's the idea. You still feel very nicely satiated from the meal. So that's why you're going to do Birkat HaMazon. So that is 72 minutes, nowadays we say. Nitakel HaMazon b'me'av eno chozer umvarech. If it's past that time, you don't feel the burden, the satiation of that meal, you do not go back. V'chein im ne'elam mimeno. ולא ידע אם בירך או לא, או אם לא בירך, חוזר ומברך, והוא שלא נתקל המזון במעט. Now if a person doesn't know, did he make the beracha, did he not make the beracha, it fits within the 72 minutes, he goes back to make a beracha. Rabbi, how could that be? We know the concept, sabal, safek, berachot, lehakel. You're in doubt to make a blessing, don't do the beracha. Why not? Mentioning Hashem's name is a Torah violation if it's in vain. You're now in doubt if you're going to fulfill a Torah violation by mentioning Hashem's name in vain, don't make the beracha. Have someone else do it for you, perform the mitzvah without the beracha. That's the concept. But as we said in our introduction, since Birkat HaMazon is a Torah obligation to make that blessing, since it's a Torah obligation and you're in doubt, safek deoraita lechumra, a doubt for a Torah obligation, you do it again. Today, you don't remember if you put on tefillin or not. Tefillin is a Torah obligation. Go on and put it on. Huh? Yeah, person didn't know. You know, if you're traveling and you didn't know. Okay, now going back to what Moises said about going back to the place. You have to do your Birkat HaMazon where you ate. Bimkom Seuda, at the same place that you ate.
Can't do it while driving in the car and leaving.
Well, driving in the car is a different story. For staying in the car, even though the car has moved, you can still do Birkat HaMazon.
You can eat a sandwich in the car.
Yeah, you can eat a sandwich in the car and do Birkat HaMazon. Talking about doing Birkat HaMazon. While you're driving is another issue. You shouldn't be praying while you're driving because then you don't have proper concentration. But let's say you're in the passenger seat, you ate, and even though you might be 100 kilometers away, you still could do Birkat HaMazon because you are in the same place. However, if you ate in a house and you left the house and you're far away, you depends how far away you are, you would need to come back. I think if it's out of your way, the halakha is, I think it's 15 minutes. If you're 15 minutes away, you still need to drive, go turn around and go back to do your Birkat HaMazon.
If you don't have the time to come back and within the 72 minutes.
Oh, so you're out, that's it, you're out.
You don't do it wherever you find.
No. Now here's another halakha. If you left and you didn't leave anybody at the meal at home, once you stepped out and you came in and you didn't have intention to go out and in, you already lost your birkat hamazon. Mm-hmm. Yeah? So meaning, if you're eating in your kitchen and then someone comes to the door, you finished your meal, someone comes to the door, you go outside, now you're in the parking lot or in the front lawn, and you're completely, as we call in halakha, misiach da'ato, you completely have forgotten about your meal, especially since you weren't planning on coming back to finish because you finished the meal, you don't do birkat hamazon.
Whoa.
Even if it's within the
72 minutes. You left, you're gone.
Oh, depends. I'm sorry. When you are traveling and you forget, if it's a long way, so you do the birkat hamazon where you are there.
You know what? Let's wait till the Rambam to get to that halachot. It could be. I know. It's not like a clear cut. I know there's many machloket in it. But the concept is if you for sure know you're coming back, you come back. Well, based on what we said,
if you can,
based on what we said, if you left and you got to come back to do birkat hamazon, so even if you left your house on purpose, you still got to come back and do birkat hamazon.
If it's in 15 minutes, right?
You won't make that mistake twice because of the punishment you just had. You just schlep all the way home. You'll go.
No, so
I'm
again,
remember.
Let's go back. Let's go back. We said it again. If you leave your house and you come back, you're still going to do birkat hamazon. Because if you did it
within 72.
If it's within 72 minutes, right? Even the case that I said about going out on the lawn, and then coming back in, yes, you will do your birkat hamazon. Exactly. Although you're getting into how do we say? No, you're getting into a disagreement amongst poskim if you've already like forgot about your seuda or not. So ideally, when you have a meal, sit down,
in
have your meal.
Both cases, you forgot.
Right. Yeah.
So. ושכחתי לעשות ברכת המזון, ונסעתי, והגעתי עד 441, איי, לא עשיתי ברכת המזון. ועשיתי, בדרך עשיתי, אפשר להגיד.
אם עשית, עשית. It's not supposed to be done, but if you
don't... זו
השאלה, אתה צריך לחזור.
האם אני אחזור, לא יבטר לי לחזור בחזר הביתה?
אז זה משהו אחר.
אז אתה אונס.
אתה אנוס. זה משהו אחר. אתה נכנסת...
Okay, let's look at the last halakha. The last halakha speaks about the contents of... Sorry, the ingredients of what constitutes as bread in order to obligate one to fulfill the mitzvah of birkat hamazon. Chamisha minin hen. There are five types of grain, which, while we soon see what has to be done to them, now constitute as bread. Hitin, wheat. Se'orim, barley. Kusmin, spelt. Shiboret shu'al is oats. And shifon is rye, or back and forth. Which way? Either or. You have barley. Wheat, barley, spelt, oats, and rye. Those are the five grains that, when we see what we do to them, now become bread. So any of these, chitin, seorim, kusmin, shiboret, sorry. Kusmin, mimin, chitin, shiboret, shu'al, shifon, mimin, seorim. V'chamisha minin ha'elu, kishehen shibolim, when they are now kernels, nikrain tevua, bechol makom. That's what's called tevua, crop, in Mishnah and in Gemara. Ve'achar shedashin ve'zorinotan. Once we thresh them and winnow them, nikrain dagan. They are now called dagan, which is the next level of getting them ready. And then ukishetohanin otan, and then ve'lashin otan. And then when you grind them into flour, ve'lashin et kimchan, and then you knead them into dough, ve'ofinotan, and then you bake them, nikra'in pat. Now that is called bread. So if I take rice and I grind it up and I make a bread out of that, is that bread? No. It's rice bread, and rice bread is a shakol, and it's a borei nefashot.
Mm-hmm. Only one of these
These five grains can you make bread that is hamotzi, that you can make a birkat hamazon on, that you can make matzah on, to fulfill the proper halakha of eating matzah. V'apat ha'naseh me'echad mehen, hi nikret pat b'chol makom b'lo livui. This bread, with no extra additives, because now when you add additives, then you change it into a mizonot. But raw bread, with the yeast, maybe salt and eggs, all of that is still considered bread. But when you start adding any sweetening to it, it could, but not always, it could become מזונות, and we'll discuss that at another time. ברוך אדוני לעולם.
אמן ואמן. קורניש מזונות,
אה? קורניש שהכל.
קורניש שהכל.